वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल. दिस इज कृति शर्मा फ्रॉम आर्या कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड आईटी, कुकर्स, जयपुर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक द करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट एंड रिटेंशन स्ट्रेटजीज MBA फोर्थ सेमेस्टर. एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द कंसेप्ट ऑफ परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द करेक्टरिस्टिक इज थरोनेस. The system should be thorough regarding all employees should be evaluated in all the dimensions, like all major job responsibilities should be evaluated, the entire review period, that is not just the few weeks or few months before the review, and on positive aspects as well as those that are needed, the improvement, these should be evaluated for the performance management appraisal process. The next concept is practicality. The systems that are too expensive, time consuming, and will obviously not be effective. On the other hand, good systems that are available and easy to use, for example, we can use the performance data that are entered in the user-friendly software form and are acceptable to those who want to use them for better decision making. So we can use the user-friendly softwares for the performance of individual employees in the organization. The next is meaningfulness. The system should be meaningful in several ways, like the standards and evaluations conducted for each job function must be considered important and relevant. Second, the performance assessment must emphasize only those functions under the control of the employee. Third, the evaluation must take place at regular intervals and at appropriate moment, means the evaluation process should be conducted time to time. The system should provide continuing skill development of evaluators, as the performance management is related to employees, and the skills of evaluators must also be developed time to time for the good decision making process. And the last is the results should be used for important personal decisions, means on the basis of that decisions, the particular employee is needed any kind of trainings, or the skills are appropriate for the specific role or a specific job. So these decisions can be take place through the particular process of the performance management review process. The next is identification of effective and ineffective performance. So what is this? The performance management system should provide information allowing for the identification of effective and ineffective performance. Means the system should allow for distinguishing between the effective and ineffective behaviors and results. So thereby also it allows for the identification of the employees displaying various levels of performance effectiveness. The next is specific. The good system should be specific, meaning that it should provide the detailed and concrete guidance to employees about what is expected of them and how they can meet these expectations. Means it should provide the overall information and overall objectives and overall review or brief review of the skills that are expected from the employees. The next is reliability. A good system should include measures of performance that are consistent and free of errors. For example, if two supervisors provided ratings of the same employee and they are using the same performance dimensions, the ratings should be similar of both the managers or both the supervisors. The next one is validity. validity, the measures of performance should be valid. In this context, measures are relevant. It may include all the critical performance facts, and that are not deficient means do not leave any important aspects out, and they are not contaminated means they do not include factors outside the control of the employee. So these should be noted. The next is inclusiveness. The good system include input from multiple sources on an ongoing basis. First, the evaluation process must represent the concerns of all the people who will be affected by the outcomes. Means the employees must participate in the process of creating the system by providing input regarding what kind of behaviors and results will be measured and how they will be measured. And the second one is the employee input about their performance should be gathered from the employees themselves before the appraisal meeting. The next characteristics is correctability. The process of assigning ratings should minimize subjective aspects. Means, however, it is virtually impossible to create a completely objective system because human judgment is an important component of the evaluation process. So the correctability means the overall objective system to evaluate the performance of employees should not be proper, or it cannot be a proper way. It should also contain some subjective matters, so that if there is any need of correctability, so the managers or supervisors can correct that. Next is openness. A good system have no secrets. The performance is evaluated frequently, and performance feedback is provided on an ongoing basis. So employees are continually informed about their performance. The appraisal meetings consist of a two-way communication process where information is exchanged and not just delivered from the supervisors to the employees. And also the standards should be cleared and communicated on an ongoing basis. Finally, the communications are factual, open and honest. The next is standardization. The good systems are standardized. This means that performance is evaluated consistently across people and time. Means the overall goal is to achieve this goal, the ongoing training of the individual in charge of appraisals. Usually it includes the managers. The managers must be included in this process compulsorily. The next is acceptability and fairness. A good system is acceptable to and perceived as fair by all participants. So how it can be a fair system? The perceptions of fairness are subjective, and the only way to know whether a system is seen as a fair, it should be asked from the participants themselves. The last one is ethicality. The good system comply with ethical standards. This means that the supervisor suppresses her personal self-interest in providing evaluation. And also in addition to this, the supervisors evaluates only performance dimensions for which she or he has sufficient information, while respecting the privacy of the employees as well. Thank you.